In this video, we'll discuss the Artemis program and find out what are its goals and how far ahead it has gone so far.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Hello and welcome. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe. The last manned mission to the moon was Apollo 17, taking place between 7 and the 19th of December 1972. It was a 12-day mission and broke many records: the longest spacewalk, the longest lunar landing, and the largest lunar samples brought back to Earth. So in the last 50 years, no other nation has gone back to the moon. NASA wants to change this with the Artemis program. The Artemis program intends to re-establish a human presence on the moon for the first time since the Apollo 17 mission in 1972. The major components of the program are the Space Launch System, SLS, Orion spacecraft, Lunar Gateway space station, and the commercial human landing systems, including Starship HLS. Artemis 1 is the first in a series of increasingly complex missions that will enable human exploration to the moon and Mars. Artemis 1 is the first test flight of the agency's new space launch system Mega Rocket and the Orion spacecraft. Artemis 1 was successfully launched from Kennedy Space Center on November 16, 2022, and its main objective is to test the Orion spacecraft, especially its heat shield, in preparation for subsequent Artemis missions. The SLS rocket launched the uncrewed Orion spacecraft on an approximately 25-day mission, during which it will orbit the moon before returning to Earth. It has 50% more habitable space than the spacecrafts of Apollo's time, allowing more room for the crew, tasks, and supplies. While Apollo allowed 3 crew members to travel in space for up to 14 days, the new Orion module allows 4 crew members to travel for up to 21 days in space. The SLS is the most powerful rocket NASA has ever built, around 15% more powerful than the Saturn V rockets that were used to get humans to the moon. The core stage, powered by 4 RS-25 engines, is accompanied by 2 solid fuel boosters. The SLS rocket will lift off the pad with 8.8 million pounds of thrust. The 4 RS-25 rocket engines accelerate the rocket to more than 17,000 miles per hour during the first 8 minutes of flight. Thanks to super-cool propellant and hot combustion gases, these rocket engines withstand temperatures ranging from minus 423 degrees Fahrenheit to more than 6,000 degrees Fahrenheit. NASA uses a popular rocket propellant, the super-cooled liquid hydrogen, and it has become the center of attention due to its unstable nature. NASA partnered with several companies to build and construct the Artemis 1 rocket, and the company tasked with manufacturing those big RS-25 engines, seen on the bottom of the rocket, is Aerojet Rocketdyne. They were manufactured in Southern California at the Canoga Park campus. The primary goals for Artemis 1 are to demonstrate Orion's systems in a spaceflight environment and ensure a safe re-entry, descent, splashdown, and recovery prior to the first flight with crew on Artemis 2. Artemis 2 will be the first crewed flight test of the Space Launch System and the Orion spacecraft around the moon. Planning is underway for a regular cadence of Artemis missions with crew on and around the moon. Artemis 3 will be the U.S. Space Agency's first crewed moon landing mission since Apollo 17 in 1972. However, NASA's long-term goals are even more ambitious. Using the technology and research developed during the Artemis flights, NASA intends to launch a future crewed mission to Mars. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe.